as residents converged at the northern division of Fort Portal City Office Grounds in Karambi to commemorate the belated Women's Day celebrations. Victoria Risoke Businje, the Minister of State for Local Government, who represented the Vice President Jessica Alupo, warned leaders over increasing corruption and mismanagement of government programs and projects.
It was getting rotten. And we are ready to fight on. We are just starting. So leaders, wake up. Stop criticism. Nimuloro muntu narwanile kirabajuna. Nimushyanja. Kunumuli? Kunumulo. Let us speak one language, that's when we shall be winners. So, in as far as fighting corruption is concerned, otukwechanga tukechanga sente za youth medica jahan. Now, Minister Walansi naja kuita.
The minister also cautioned women on child upbringing. The minister also cautioned women on child upbringing by asking mothers to mentor their children morally, spiritually, and culturally.
Children who are not guided. Abana abatafirweho. Children who are not being cared for. They go like lost sheep. They listen to anything. They survive on anything. You don't need to be a millionaire to bring up a morally up child. In your family. We all did grow up in rich families, but our parents cared, guided, counseled, directed, and punished. They supported us in school. They guided us to protect our bodies. They taught us self-satisfaction.
Leaders advised women to embrace government programs. However, they pointed out a number of issues affecting implementation of programs.
The PDM program is simple. When there is no leadership at the world level, they will not keep their money. Because the chairman, LOCFO and the committee, they are supposed to oversee the implementation of that program.
21 parishes that have registered circles. The other 4 parishes have not yet registered. Reason is the 3 parishes are newly created parishes which have not been gazetted. But as members of parliament, when recently we were sent on oversight role, we made a report which has already been tabled to parliament, and some of our recommendations are 1, Ministry of Finance to provide funds for these parishes so that the electoral commission is able to carry out elections of the lower local leaders of these administrative units.
Relatedly, a section of women celebrated the belated Women's Day around an organized community fireplace that is traditionally known as a choto. The women leaders explain that they decided to hold the celebration in a unique way that was integrated in their culture. During the session, several strategies on how women can benefit from government programs were discussed.
We are trying to bring back our norms, try to speak and empower these girls to go back to school, to engage in the government programs, mostly like skilling, and also empower women, because most of them have faced gender-based violence in their homes. To make people remember their culture, like all things we used to do with our grandparents. We wanted to bring our culture back. Women, we are the key of success in everything, and we are the lead in our culture. We wanted to remember our culture.
Alice Basemera says revival of a choto evening sessions is fundamental in the fight against domestic and gender-based violence, as well as training girls on respect and cultural values.
At first, people were using a choto where they were sitting with their children, with their aunties, the uncles, to discuss what exactly they can do as a family so that they cannot go into violence. It was helping them, but since that time, they didn't use a choto, they stopped using a choto, so that is why we are seeing the violence is too much.
In Toro culture, a choto is a norm that is traditionally practiced. The family and clan heads chair the a choto sessions that are characterized by traditional dances, storytelling, important and sensitive discussions, quizzes with accompaniments, lots of eats and drinks. Report by Dori Nasima and Roger Sunday for the news.